Hi guys, welcome back to today's video. Today, GigiLab is going to talk about this Lenovo Legion 135W charger, which can support Lenovo Private Protocol for the latest Y9000 series. The front of the packaging is printed with the product name. A blue and white Lenovo icon is on the lower right corner. Flip to the back, here are some specs info. Open the box, here are two charging cables and the charger. The first one is the Lenovo customized cable, which can achieve 135 watts after connecting to the power port of the latest Lenovo laptop. The square connector is yellow, and the cable is about 1.53 meters. The ChargerLab Power ZKM002C shows it has an eMarker chip. Since the KM002C cannot detect Lenovo private protocol, we can only see 100 watts instead of 135 watts. The second one is the dual USB-C cable, and the length is about 1.5 meters. KM002C shows it also integrates the eMarker chip. And then let's remove the plastic film. This charger adopts traditional shape and looks like a black brick. The 135 watts and Legion are on the front and back. This charger adopts fixed prongs, and the model is LA135. It can support input of 100 to 240 volts, 50 or 60 hertz, 2.5 amp, and the output is 5, 9, 12, 15 volts, 3 amp, 20 volts, 6.75 amp, 135 watts max. Here is the single USB-C port. The size of the charger is about 65, 66, and 31 millimeter. So the power density is about 1 watt cubic centimeter. And the weight is about 290 grams. It's significantly shorter than Apple 140 watt charger. The ChargerLab Power ZKT002 shows it supports QC2, QC3, PD3, and PPS fast charging protocols. The Lenovo private protocol cannot be detected. It also has 5 fixed PDLs of 5 volts, 3 amp, 9 volts, 3 amp, 12 volts, 3 amp, 15 volts, 3 amp, 20 volts, 5 amp, and a set of PPS. Okay, after the brief introduction of this charger, let's go ahead and take it apart. Firstly, try to use the spider to open it. It doesn't work. Then let's use the cutting machine to open it. Take out the internal PCB module, which is wrapped with PureWork copper heatsink to enhance heat dissipation and make sure the stability of high power charging. The heatsink is fixed on the PCB, and the red and purple wires are insulated by silicon adhesives. Remove the heatsink, and we can see the black insulating plate. Continue to remove it, and the entire PCBA is filled with silicon adhesives. ChargerLab found it adopts QR topology and has PFC circuit. Then let's start from the input to introduce all components. Firstly, the upper and lower PCBs are supported by plastic brackets. The specs of Conquer Fuse are 5A 250 volts. This is the first common mode choke, and here is the second one. The Safety X2 capacitor is 0.33 microfarad from Jinhao. The X capacitor discharge chip is from Chipon PN8200. They can form the EMI filter circuit. After that, we can see the bridge rectifier here, which comes from HYGBJ2508, 25M 800 volts. Two SMDY capacitors are on the back of the PCB from Holystone. The specs of the two film capacitors are 1 microfarad, 450 volts. This is the toroidal core inductor. This charger is equipped with PFC circuit. And the PFC controller comes from MPS MP44018A, which has multimode with enhanced light load efficiency. The PFC MOSFET is from NCE Power and adopts TO220F package, 650 volts, 110 milliohm. The PFC boost rectifier is from WIN, which is an ultra-fast recovery diode and adopts TO252 package, 600 volts, 9 amp. And this is PFC boost inductor. Those four electrolytic capacitors are from Chenxing, 18 microfarad, 420 volts. The other one is 27 microfarad, 420 volts, 99 microfarad in total. The mass control chip is from MPS MPX2002, which integrates primary flyback controller, secondary rectifier controller, and supports CCM and QR modes. The primary MOSFET is from Navitas NV6136A, which integrates linearless current sampling technology and does not require external resistors. The building driver supports 10 to 30 volts power supply and 2 MHz switching frequency, so it can save space and improve conversion efficiency. The filter capacitor that powers the PFC controller and the primary controller is from Suscon, 50 microfarad, 100 volts. The transformer is wrapped with heat-resistant tape for insulation. The synchronous rectifier is from NCE Power and adopts TOLL package, 100 volts, 1.7 milliohm. The CT1018 optocoupler can adjust the output voltage detected by the protocol chip. There are two solid output capacitors. This one is 1000 microfarad, 25 volts. The other one is from Polycab, 680 microfarad, 25 volts. The USB-C receptacle is vertically soldered on the small PCB, and the protocol chip is on the back. This is a rubber sealing ring in here. The protocol chip is from Weltrend WT6636F, which can support QC4+, PD3, and PPS protocols. It integrates 10-bit ADC for voltage and current detection, discharge MOSFET, and low-side current sampling amplifier. The NTC thermistor can detect the internal temperature for overheat protection. The output VBUS MOSFET is from NCE Power and adopts DFN5x6 package, 40 volts, 1.09 milliohm. Well, that's all the components for this Lenovo Legion charger. The internal layout of the charger is pretty compact. Since it is pretty small, the entire module is covered with pure copper heatsink and filled with silicon adhesives to ensure charging stability. If you are the user of the latest Lenovo laptop that can support 135W charging and want to find a smaller charger to replace the original one, you can consider this charger. Okay, that's all for today's video. You can also click the corners to view the relative videos. Please drop a like, leave your comments, and subscribe to us. I'll catch you guys in the next video. Bye!